And we are writing them in our full intercept form. If you remember, I did tell you last class. You've got to remember that that's referred to as a full intercept form. We're not going to keep calling it why it's on my spreadsheet. On your reason for that, it will tell you to write your equation 1 in full intercept form. You need to know that vocabulary word. You guys know pretty well, slope is your M, your y-intercept is your B. If your y-intercept were to be written as a point, it would be 0, comma, B. So whatever your B value is, it's 0, comma, that number. So you've got negative 3, 0, comma, negative 3. You've got 4, 0, comma, 4. So when you are writing the equation of the line, you have to first identify your slope, and then you have to identify your y-intercept, and then you go ahead and write the equation of your line. So looking at my graph here, the easiest thing to find first is your y-intercept. So my y-intercept here is a 1. We'll put that next to the y-intercept. To find my slope, I'm going to pick another point anywhere on the graph where it can cross. You guys can see the little grid lines there. And you're going to go from the point on the left to the point on the right. So here I'm going to count up 1, 2, goes over to the right in 1, and you can tell me what is our slope. Rise over 1. I went up 2 first and then to the right 1. So the equation for our line would be y equals 2x plus 1. Your angle is like your x. Y is up to that one. So let's take a look at the next one. Graph C. What is the y value? Y-intercept. There it is. Negative. So then I'm going to pick another point that hits the grid line nice and evenly. Does not matter which one you pick. So if I count left to right, I go down first. 1, 2, 3. So that's a negative 3. To the right, 1, 2, 3, 4. So our slope would be negative 3, 4. So what would our equation be? Y equals what? Negative 3 over 4x. Minus 3. Now it's really easy if they give you ones like example number 2. It tells you to write the equation of the line with a slope of negative 3 and a y-intercept of 5. You don't even need to count anything. How would we write our line? Y equals what? Negative 3x plus 5. So now for number 3, again, it tells us to write the equation of the line. Whenever you see that phrase, you should automatically be thinking y equals mx squared in your head there. For a line that passes through the point 0, negative 1, and has a slope of 4. So I know my x is 4. Now, as I was telling you up above, since your x-coordinate here is a 0, this means your b value is negative 1. Whenever you get to 0, that is your y-intercept. So the equation of our line would be 4x minus 1. So for the fourth one, write the equation of a line, the y-intercept is 0, and a slope of 2/3. And you can tell me y equals what? What is it? 2 over 3x. Could I put the plus 0? How does it work wrong if I put the plus 0, but we don't have to have it for the plus 0. So y equals 2/3. Is write the equation of a line with a slope of 4 and passes through the point 3, 5. Do I know my y-intercept yet? No. I know my slope is 4. I don't know if the other part is my equation. I need to know my b value in order to we're still going to use our Y tool on our Excel sheet, and we're going to plug in the information that we know. We know our M is a 4. From the point that they gave us, we have an X coordinate and we have a Y coordinate, so we're going to use those to find our B value. So I'm going to put my 5 in for Y. I'm going to put 3 in for my X. We're looking for B. So I'm going to solve this. 4 times 3 is a 12. And what do we want to do with our 12? Subtract it over. So 5 minus 12 gives us what for our B value? Negative 7. Y equals 4x minus 7. That was the only one that was going to be. So even if they don't give you your slope, you can still calculate your slope. You know that. So this one, we're given a table of values. They want us to write the equation number 1. So again, in order to write the equation of the line, I need to know those two things. I need to know my slope and I need to know my y-intercept. Looking at my table, I've got nothing so far. So I'm going to pick 2 points. So I'll pick 1 negative 3, which is 2. And I'm going to calculate my slope. y2 minus y1, so 2 minus a negative 3, over x2. Minus x. So what happens when we subtract the negative? Yeah. So that's a 5 over 5. Which is equal to what? 1. So now we have our slope. We have a slope of 1. So then to get my b value, I always look at my table. Do I have any x values of 0? No. So I can't find my value that way. So we need to plug in like we did this example up here. Using our y equals mx plus b, you can pick any point in the table that you want. I'm going to use the middle point just because I haven't used that one yet. So I have a y value of negative 1. We just calculated our slope to be a 1. X value from my point is a 3. So 1 times 3 gives us 3. And then what do we want to do with that 3? Subtract it over. So what is our b value?
Negative
4. So now we can write our equation of the line. Y equals We could write it as 1x minus 4, but we don't have to write the 1. So number 2, a video game developer is designing a game to solve a puzzle. The points in the game are awarded based on the table in the game below, where scores administered based on the time it takes you to solve the puzzle. Write an equation for the developer to use that models the table. Again, we need to know two things, slope and y-intercept, in order to write our equation for the developer. Looking at my table, I have an x value that's a 0, which means what is the 1,000? That's our y-intercept. Whenever x is 0, that y value that goes with it is the y-intercept. So I already know my b value. We need to calculate our slope now. So again, I'll put 2 points. I always do top and bottom. y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. Negative 4. 0. And then a 3. John, Tori, Eric, what do you think?
Y equals negative 2/3 x plus 1,000.
Now keep in mind that if you don't use your equals to negative 2/3, you will lose some points. You gotta remember, you